you're never, when you give an attorney presentation, they're not just going to fall over. They're not just going to not say anything, fall over and go, here, take everything. That's just not the real world. And they have common obstacles, and then some of them are just crap. They're just stupid, you know, ignorant, stupid crap. And so one of the things that I wanted to share with you is how to handle an obstacle. Now, I'm going to give you a generic formula for handling an obstacle. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to write it out, and I'll email it out so you can actually just memorize. And when they give obstacles, that's exactly what you're going to want to say. But I want to take just a minute to give you the concept. So what's happening when you with this obstacle thing? Well, remember, as you're going through establishing need, in other words, it's hurting, okay? They will either go into avoidance or denial. And by the way, that's bad. And when they go into avoidance and denial, I'll cover that later, how to handle that. But that's really bad. And that takes a black belt strategy. You have to know that's black belt sales. When somebody goes into avoidance and denial, you better have that's black belt. That's not naive. To actually get that person back into the game and get their business, that's a black belt strategy. That's not, you know, that's not just some pathetic, weak little line. So I'll cover that later. But you never want it to get to that point. And the number one reason it'll get to that point is you'll cover too much too fast. In other words, you won't do micro steps. And chances are you did not follow that presentation, or if you followed it, you did not reverse the attorney and get his micro agreements at each step. In other words, you just kept moving on, and then you covered too many topics. He wasn't in agreement, and then he kind of jumps out and goes into avoidance and denial.